Now, Mycobacterium tuberculosis is usually transmitted via inhalation, which is how they gain entry into the lungs. Now, we breathe in all sorts of virus and bacteria all the time, but we've got defenses that take care of most of them. For one, air that we breathe in is turbulent in the upper airways, and drives most bacteria against mucus, which is then cleared pretty quickly. Ultimately though, TB can avoid the mucus traps and make its way to the deep airways and alveoli, where we have macrophages that eat up foreign cells, digest, and destroy them. With TB, they recognize foreign proteins on their cell surface and phagocytize them, or essentially package them into a space called a phagosome. With most cases, the macrophage then fuses the phagosome with a lysosome, which has hydrolytic enzymes that can pretty much break down any biochemical molecule. TB is tricky though, and once inside the macrophage, they produce a protein that inhibits this fusion, which allows the mycobacterium to survive. It doesn't just survive though, it proliferates and creates a localized infection. At this point, somebody has developed primary tuberculosis, which means that they have signs of infection soon after being exposed to TB. Even though it sounds bad, most people at this stage are actually asymptomatic, or maybe have a mild flu-like illness. About 3 weeks after initial infection, cell-mediated immunity kicks in, and immune cells surround the site of TB infection, creating a granuloma, essentially an attempt to wall off the bacteria and prevent it from spreading. The tissue inside the middle dies as a result, a process referred to as caseous necrosis, which means cheese-like necrosis, since the dead tissue is soft, white, and looks kind of like cheese. This area is known as a gone focus. TB also gets the hilar lymph nodes, either carried over by immune cells through the lymph or by direct extension of the gone focus infection, and causes caseation there as well. And together, this caseating tissue and associated lymph node make up the characteristic gone complex. Gone complexes are usually subpleural and occur in the lower lobes of the lungs. The tissue that's encapsulated by the granuloma undergoes fibrosis, and often calcification, producing scar tissue that can be seen on x-ray. This calcified gone complex is called a Ranke complex. In some cases, although a scar is left over, the mycobacteria is killed off by the immune system, and that's the end of that. In other cases, even though they're walled off, they remain viable, and are therefore still alive, but they're just dormant,